In this question, we're given two graphs and eight exponential equations, or eight exponential functions. We want to match the correct equation to the correct graph. Recall all the equations are in the form of f of x or y equals b to the power of x. For exponential functions, b must be greater than 0 and b can't equal 1. If b is greater than 1, we have exponential growth and the function is always increasing. If b is between 0 and 1, we have exponential decay and the function is always decreasing. For all functions in this form, the y-intercept is always 0, 1. Y equals 0 is a horizontal asymptote, and below we have the domain and range. Before we look at this using Desmos.com, notice for the first four equations, b is 2, 3, 4, and 5, and for the second set of equations, b is 1 half, 1 third, 1 fourth, and 1 fifth. So we should recognize for the first four equations, we have exponential growth, and therefore the red graph must be one of the first four equations. And for the second set of equations, b is between 0 and 1, and therefore we have exponential decay, and therefore the blue graph must match with one of these last four equations. And now let's go to Desmos.com. I've already set this up. Right now we have y equals b to the power of x, where b is equal to 2, shown on the graph, meaning this is the graph of y equals 2 to the power of x. And now let's see how the graph changes as b increases from 2 to 5. Here we have b equals 3, b equals 4, and b equals 5. Notice as the base increases from 2 to 5, the exponential growth function increases faster and faster. Also notice the y-intercept remains the point 0, 1. And now let's go ahead and turn this graph off, and we'll look at the graph of y equals 1 divided by a to the power of x. Notice where a is the denominator. So if I turn this on the right we have the graph of y equals 1 half to the power of x because a is equal to 2. Notice we do have exponential decay, meaning the graph is decreasing. And now let's see what happens to the graph as the base changes from 1 half to 1 third to 1 fourth to 1 fifth. So here we have y equals 1 third to the power of x. Here we have y equals 1 fourth to the power of x. Here we have y equals 1 fifth to the power of x. Notice as the denominator increases from 2 to 5, or the base decreases from 1 half to 1 fifth, the function decreases faster and faster. And again, the y-intercept remains the point 0, 1. So going back to our question, notice for all eight functions, when x is equal to 0, y is equal to 1, notice in both graphs, the y-intercept is the point 0, 1. Again, we should recognize the red graph as an increasing function, and therefore we have exponential growth, and therefore the equation must be from the first row. Let's find another point on the red function and then determine which equation the ordered pair would satisfy. So let's go ahead and find this point here, the point 1, 3, which means when x is 1, y must equal 3. So let's determine the y values for all four of these first functions when x equals 1. For y equals 2 to the power of x, notice when x is 1, y is equal to 2 to the first or 2. This point is not on the function, and therefore this first equation is not correct. For y equals 3 to the power of x, when x is 1, notice y is equal to 3 to the first or 3. Notice the graph does contain the point 1, 3. Let's go ahead and continue. For y equals 4 to the power of x, when x is 1, y is equal to 4. For y equals 5 to the power of x, when x is 1, y is equal to 5. We should now be able to recognize y equals 3 to the power of x is the equation that produces the red graph on the left. It's the only equation where the ordered pair 1, 3 satisfies the equation, or when x equals 1, the output or y value is 3. Let's label the graph with the correct equation. And now let's focus on the blue graph. Let's find a second point on the graph. We could use the point negative 1, 2. Or let's look at the point when x is 1. When x is 1, notice the y value appears to be 1 half. The ordered pair is 1, 1 half. Again, notice for the last four equations, when x is 0, the y value is 1. So again, let's determine the y value when x is equal to 1. So for y equals 1 half to the power of x, notice when x is 1, y is equal to 1 half, which does seem to match our graph. For y equals 1 third of the x, when x is 1, y is equal to 1 third. For y equals 1 fourth to the x, when x is 1, y is equal to 1 fourth. And for y equals 1 fifth to the power of x, when x is 1, y is equal to 1 fifth. Let's go back to the first equation now and check the y value when x is negative 1. Notice when x is negative 1, we'd have 1 half to the power of negative 1, which is equal to positive 2. And the graph does contain the point negative 1, 2, which indicates the equation for the blue graph is y equals 1 half to the power of x. I hope you found this helpful.